get John?
Don't bring that one-legged motherfucker in here. I want to get the goddamn magazine and go and sit on the fucking stoop. I'm finished.
Get this guy up.
Steve Quinn, one of the world's greatest hecklers, right? He's featured in the New York American Poets Cafe last week. One of New York's greatest hecklers, you know, and he's famous for it. So absorb this culture. You're getting off this guy.
Dial a heckler. Our next offering is by a friend of mine who writes. His name is John Farris. Please welcome John Farris.
Where's the boat?
One-legged, huh? All
right. He's still got two. You sound like you got throat cancer, too.
I'm fucking Mr. King. Here comes Mr. King.
Get some press.
There we are. Well, I'm proud to be part of this little piece of shit here. And I'd like to thank the publisher and the other editors for allowing me to participate. This first poem, the New Yorker, every time I have anything to do with those people, I regret it.
Can you be a little more specific?
They tell me.
Who exactly do you regret? I mean, what people, what person? Name. Who is this
guy?
We all know who you're talking about.
Who's this guy?
But Bob Holman said that they were going to have a heckler's reading because we were thrown out of there for assisting the poetic mode. You know, we were thrown out bodily.
When was this?
So that was in, I don't know, when was that?
September, October, last year?
Last year, sometime.
So anyway, Bob Holman decided that he would have a heckler special and invite us all back. And this was just last week. So when Lois Lane Griffith got up and she was advertising the t-shirt and Bob said it was all right to heckle, I said, breasts. Now, no one understood why I said that because no one pays attention to what's going on around them anymore. But the New York State Supreme Court had just allowed you ladies to jiggle in parks and beaches. So I thought breasts was fine. Breasts. I love breasts. Don't you love breasts? You like breasts? I like them. Anyway. But, so what happened was, why I didn't like them anymore, but again, was I misunderstood it.
What the fuck's taking you so long?
I thought that a heckler's reading would be
come on.
That Steve Cannon would read. And be heckled.
There you go, man.
Pedro Pesci would read.
Do it right now.
And be heckled.
Come on, poetry.
Dennis
come on,
Aron
read.
Would
what
read
is this shit? Come on.
I would read and be heckled.
Fuck you.
Read the fucking poem.
So I wrote a heckler's poem.
I want to hear
about 3 years before the incident. You know, all this is old, funky shit. And this one is your nasty mouth. Imagine if the dentist was your mother, and because you were bad, needed root canal therapy. It's all your father's fault, because their own teeth are perfect, And if you had flossed when you brushed the distal three times a day as well as the lateral vigorously, you wouldn't be needing this. Always on somebody else's nerves comes to this. Hold still. Open your nasty mouth wider, like the trunk of your father's family tree. The nerve of you, she would say. What nerve? Twisting the little screw, winding it tighter. Here's a little TV poem. Well, no way. Just when you think the sun is out, here he comes like a rainy day with fog in it and everything, nimbus clouds and nothing to eat. Not one bean in his pocket. Talk about your bad news bellwethers. Gee whiz, eyes, wet wool gets pulled over. Didn't do nothing, officer.
Nice.
This was actually written a long time. It's never been typed up. See, nobody appreciates my shit. It gets thrown away. But this was for. Saw that bush. They try to tell you this old shit is some old Texas Longhorn bullshit. I know what's up. Inauguration day, the fingers. All of them give you the finger. Some give you the thumb up. Others would have it down on you, drunken bug or hapless gladiator out of favor with the people. Still others prefer to give you the middle finger, upright curled or upright and stiffened, although in most cases facing you and rotated rapidly from right to left or left to right, depending on which hand is habitually employed by the finger, or which ever hand the ambidextrous find handy at the time they finger you. Then
wonders why they don't.
God damn it, Muffet gave me the wrong book.
Oops. Yeah.
I better read it. God damn it.
Piece of shit. You didn't call me an asshole yet. I don't believe that.
This is name of the name. You're a whore too. You're just like I am, she said. I hadn't known she was a whore until just that moment. When I called her that, I had meant psychologically. I looked at her down at her champagne glass-sized breasts, her slim boyish hips. I thought about when she asked me how much the girls made on Wife and Grand. When I told her about 15 or 20, the face she made could have stopped to watch. It was a long, serious moment. But they haven't much imagination, I said. You could get 1,000. She said all black males wanted was to pimp a white woman. She was too sophisticated. A child was growing in her stomach. She thought words were lies. I told her words were like those girls. She could learn to love them if she tried hard. So here I go from here.
Good.
I'm sorry I couldn't read that other, because I wanted to.
Come on, read it.
All right. Four poems, and this is that was the last one. Magic. That you love me is preternatural. Imagine 4, 9, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 6. That's what I dreamt the night we met. I thought you some number. You needed a ride. I said, oh, Senorita, I want to take you for a ride. You said, oh yeah, though your lips never moved. You just sat veiled, looking to Rachel, mysterious lady passenger in a stagecoach, on a stagecoach. Confused, you weren't headed west. I tipped my hat 3 times. I blew some smoke to a primary directions. I mumbled something you couldn't understand. I knew it to be in color. In variation, the third act of my life, I arise with a curtain. From the three points, heralds, no sun, daughters. I am not good. More clouds from my altar, ergo, summon wise man. Fool laughs. Bad news is what is wrong with you, Elizabeth. And then Ikitote, you know, this is from the Ikks, the Ikk in over there in Central Africa, over there in Central West Africa. Winter leaves me breathless. It hangs fires in my chest like April, May, or June. Somebody pale, dancing feebly, just out of reach. My stomach is a zoo. Nobody's fed for days. I cough up teeth, feathers, bones, viscera, traces of meat. Something's missing. Read a book. I need a book to describe what's missing in me. Cough up liver. Read that. Baraz, Baraz, it says, which in Ikitot means tomorrow, tomorrow, too. Sky peels away from itself. Chips fly where they may. The fever of the last season dying over. Morning pigeons coo in the eaves to wake the dead urban roosters. The whole world white for miles. What a sloppy way to go. Shocked. I had loved it like a fond relative, and saddened I get out my best black coat, black hat, gloves, tie on my thick black scarf tight around my neck like a noose. Great days cut down in their prime. Outside is muffled, funereal, except for a few kids. But you know, kids, they never did have proper respect.
John Farris, ladies and gentlemen.